हेलो हाय गाइस, आई वेलकम यू टू स्मार्ट किडा करंट अफेयर्स मॉक टेस्ट 10th जून। इंडियन ऑयल कॉरपोरेशन हैज साइंड अ मेमोरेंडम ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग विद गुजरात गवर्नमेंट टू इन्वेस्ट हाउ मेनी करोड्स इन 6 प्रोजेक्ट्स इन द गुजरात रिफाइनरी इन कोयाली वडोदरा डिस्ट्रिक्ट गुजरात। काइंडली गिव मी द करेक्ट आंसर। हाउ मेनी करोड्स आर गोइंग टू बी इन्वेस्टेड बाय IOCL? इट इज़ वन ऑफ द मेजर ऑयल कंपनीज इन इंडिया। द आंसर इज 24,000 करोड़। So Indian Oil Corporation Limited has said that it will expand the Gujarat refinery in Vadodara, where it will invest 24,000 crore in 6 different projects, including India's first hydrogen dispensing station, said Dharmendra Pradhan, Union Minister for Petroleum and Natural Gas. These projects will expand the present capacity of Gujarat refinery in Vadodara to 18 million metric ton from 13.7 million metric ton presently, and will provide 25,000 direct and indirect jobs. Gujarat Maritime Board is going to set up India's first international maritime services cluster at Gift City. The Gift City is located in which city of Gujarat? The answer is that the Gift City is located in Ahmedabad. So, Gujarat Maritime Board, that is GMB, will set up India's first international maritime services cluster at the Gift City, the state transport operator and regulator informed. The maritime cluster will be developed as a dedicated ecosystem comprising ports, shipping, logistics services providers and pertinent government regulator, all present in the same geographic vicinity of the Gift City. Who among the following has recently released an e-booklet titled 20 Reforms in 2020, highlighting the major reform undertaken by the Ministry of Defence in 2020 in New Delhi? The answer is our Defence Minister, Mr. Rajnath Singh. So, Raksha Mantri Rajnath Singh released an e-booklet titled 20 Reforms in 2020, highlighting the major reforms undertaken by the Ministry of Defence. So, one of the major reforms of indigenization of the armed forces, they are going for indigenous procurement of arms. It happened after the China's Galwan clash. State-owned Green Mobility Promotion Agency Convergence Energy Services Limited has signed a pact with which UT administration to make the Union Territory carbon neutral? The answer is that the Union Territory which is going to be carbon neutral is Ladakh. So, state-owned Green Mobility Promotion Agency, Convergence Energy Services Limited, has signed a pact with Ladakh administration to make the Union Territory carbon neutral. Under this pact, CESL is reportedly to help the Ladakh administration to develop electric mobility solutions. Which firm has formed a joint venture company, Ratle Hydroelectric Power Corporation Limited, for the implementation of strategic 850 megawatt Ratle Hydroelectric project in Jammu and Kashmir? The answer is that this Ratle Hydroelectric Power Corporation Limited is going to be implemented in NHPC Limited. So it's have formed a joint venture company for strategic Ratle Hydro project in JNK. This is a state-run company, and the total project megawatt capacity is 850 megawatt. Which of the following IITs has recently hosted Asia's first workshop on memory studies? So which of the following IITs has recently hosted it? The answer is IIT Madras. So IIT Madras has hosted Asia's first international memory studies workshop. It precedes the official launch of the Indian Network for Memory Studies and brought together participants from all over the world. Conducted from April 26 to 2021, the workshop has 108 registered participants. Which firm has recently launched iFamilia, a global database to identify missing person? The answer is that iFamilia was launched by Interpol. So Interpol have launched a new global database iFamilia to identify missing persons through family DNA and help the police solve cold cases in member countries. So this will help. This will apply cutting edge scientific research and use the DNA of relatives to identify missing persons or unidentified human remains around the world. Very important. Which country has been elected to the UN Economic and Social Council for the 22-24 term? The answer is that the country that has been elected to UN Economic and Social Council is India. So India has been elected to the United Nations Economic and Social Council, UN ECOSOC, for a 2-year period starting next year. ECOSOC is one of the 6 main arms of the UN. This is a 54-member ECOSOC that aims to advance 3 dimensions of sustainable development that are economic, social and environmental, that is arthik, samajik or paryavaran se related. G7 nations has made an agreement to introduce a global minimum corporate tax rate of at least how many percent for multinational companies? The answer is 15%. So the group of seven advanced economies on June 5 secured a landmark deal on taxing multinational companies, as per which the minimum global tax rate would be at least 15%. The agreement by finance minister of US, UK, Germany, France, Canada, Italy and Japan paves way for levies on multinationals in countries where they operate. Heidelberg Cement is planning to build the world's first CO2 neutral cement plant. Where is this world's first CO2 neutral cement plant situated? The answer is Sweden. So Heidelberg Cement plans first CO2 neutral cement plant by 2030 in Sweden. The company says a feasibility study is underway to select a carbon capture technology for a slight plant on the island of Gotland. It aims to capture the plant's full emissions by 2030 and this will be stored offshore. It will increase the share of biofuels used to fuel operations at the plant. Name the person who has been appointed as the educational advisor of the World Bank. The answer is that the educational advisor of World Bank is Ranjit Singh Disale. So, primary school teacher and Global Teacher Prize 2020 winner Ranjit Singh Disale has been named as the World Bank Education Advisor for the period June 2021 to June 2024. We will be associated with the World Bank's COACH project, which aims to accelerate student learning by improving in-service teacher professional development. Which of the following IITs has recently developed nanofiber-based oral tablets of amphotericin B called as MB to treat fungal infections post-COVID treatment? The answer is this has been developed by nanofiber-based oral tablets by IIT Hyderabad. So IIT Hyderabad, that is Indian Institute of Technology Hyderabad, has developed this nanofiber-based oral tablets of amphotericin B called as MB to treat fungal infections post-COVID treatment. Currently, the AMB is available in injectable form. Which of the following state has recently launched Chief Minister Anup Pratik coaching scheme so as to help underprivileged students prepare for entrance examinations? The answer is Rajasthan. So Rajasthan has launched Chief Minister Anup Pratik coaching scheme so as to help underprivileged students prepare for entrance examinations for civil services and professional courses with an aim to give them equal opportunity, said a circular issued by the State Finance Department. Students belonging to scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, other backward classes, extremely backward classes, minority and economically weaker sections with income below 8 lakh per annum will be available to avail the scheme run by Tribal Area Development, Minority Affairs and Social Justice Empowerment Departments. Which state has become the first state to use NFSC-based EIDs? Kindly give the correct answer. The answer is Punjab. So Punjab has become the first state to use NFC-based EIDs. Consistent with the development across the globe, the digital identification playing cards have been launched in quite a few nations. Punjab authorities have additionally initiated the utilization of EIDs outfitted with close-to-area communication expertise. So it's very important. Which state government has announced the launch of eNirman web portal? This is a mobile application to facilitate online registration of workers from unorganized sector to enroll them for various government welfare schemes. Kindly give the correct answer. This eNirman web portal and mobile application has been made by Gujarat. So Gujarat has launched the eNirman web portal app for unorganized sector workers. According to the state administration, the new portal will intend to create a database for all the workers from unorganized sectors in the state and roll out special smart cards to them for easy access to state-funded welfare schemes. World Accreditation Day 2021 was observed on which day? The answer is World Accreditation Day was observed on June 9th. So June 9th marks the World Accreditation Day. It's here. Accreditation is very important with stakeholders, regulators and consumers of how accreditation may be applied to meet objectives such as increasing trade, addressing environment and health and safety concerns and improving the general overall quality of output in an economy. Choguel Kokala Maiga has been named as the new Prime Minister of which country? The answer is Choguel Kokala Maiga has been named as the Prime Minister of Mali. So President of Strategic Committee of the Movement of June 5, Rally of Patriotic Forces, Choguel Kokala Maiga was appointed on Monday as Mali's transitional prime minister by Malian transitional president Assimi Goïta. This was confirmed by the Malian presidency in a press conference read on television, national television. RBI has granted approval of reappointment of Chandrasekhar Ghosh as the managing director and chief executive officer of which bank for a period of 3 years? Kindly give the correct answer. So Chandrasekhar Gore is going to be the MD and CEO of Bandhan Bank for a period of 3 years with effect from 10th July 2021. This reappointment is subject to the approval of shareholders at the ensuing annual general meeting of the bank. Reserve Bank of India has extended the tenure of Deputy Governor Mahesh Kumar Jain for how many years? The answer is that his tenure is extended by 2 years. So he got a 2 year extension, RBI Deputy Governor MK Jain. Who among the following has recently been appointed as the new election commissioner? The answer is, new election commissioner is Anup Chandra Pandey. Former Chief Secretary of Uttar Pradesh Anup Chandra Pandey has been appointed as the election commission, said the Union Law and Justice Ministry statement on Monday. He is an administrative officer of the 1984 batch and now he has been appointed as the EC. Thank you for watching, dear friends. Have a nice time.